Hello everyone. Today we're going to discuss the summary of lesson 2 from Moments, and the name of the lesson is The Adventures of Toto, and it is written by a very famous writer and his name is Ruskin Bond. This story describes how the author's grandfather was fond of animals. The grandfather bought Toto, a monkey, from a tanga driver for 5 rupees and decided to keep him in his private zoo. Toto was a pretty monkey with mischief in his eyes. His pearly white teeth would scare the elderly Anglo-Indian ladies. His tail served as his third hand. Grandfather decided to keep Toto in a closet in the narrator's room. He torn off the wallpaper and shredded the narrator's school blazer. But grandfather was pleased with his performance. Grandmother was always fussy about any new animal added to the private zoo, so Toto's presence was kept a secret from her. He was transferred to a large cage in the servants' quarter, along with a tortoise, a pair of rabbit, a tame squirrel, and a goat. Grandfather took Toto along with him to Saharanpur to collect his pension. He carried him in a big black canvas kit bag. However, Toto made effort to come out of it, but his efforts only made the bag to jump into the air or roll about the bag on the floor. While traveling on the train, the ticket collector considered Toto as a dog, and thus he charged 3 rupees extra from grandfather. Grandfather did not like it, and he took his pet turtle if he would charge for that too. He did not charge more as it was not a dog. That's what the ticket collector told the grandfather. Toto was finally accepted by grandmother, and he was given a comfortable home in the stable shared with the family donkey Nana. But at night, Toto fastened himself on to her ear with sharp little teeth and did not make friends with her. Toto liked to take bath in a large bowl of warm water given by grandmother during cold winter evenings. He would cunningly check the water if it was warm enough to take bath and not hot enough to burn him. After bath, he would run straight to the kitchen fire to dry himself up. He would get hurt if someone would laugh at his act of bathing. Once, he almost half boiled himself after getting into large kitchen kettle left on the fire. Grandmother shouted him out of the kettle in time. Toto was so full of mischief that he would tear a hole in the dresses of the narrator's aunt. Once Toto stuffed his mouth with rice at the dining table and threw a plate at grandmother. Later, grandfather realized that Toto was not the sort of pet to keep for long, so he sold him back to tanga driver for 3 rupees. So this was the story of naughty Toto. I hope you understood the chapter very well. And now when you look at the questions of this chapter, it will be easy for you to answer all of them.